You know, I never know how to start off these LPs. I don't want to sound like Phil and go like, "All right, hello everyone."
Well, but I think it might be a good idea to explain why we're doing this.
Sure. Well, hello everyone. I'm Mega, and with me for Lords of the Fallen, as always, is Lich.
Hey.
And we're doing an LP of Lords of the Fallen. Since we've seen two people play this game terribly, I might as well make it 2.5. So what's happening is we're overdubbing a previous recording of a previous recording. Mm-hmm. And I don't know how that's going to turn out. What happened was I tried streaming it with my PlayStation 4. That was when it was called Mega Dinks Around with Lords of the Fallen. And the audio, the video quality was complete shit.
Like, yeah, it just didn't turn out well.
I could not upload that to YouTube in good mental health and just be like, yeah, you know what, that's fine, I'm alright with it. Good conscience, that's the word I'm looking for. Mental health, wow. So then, I went back on my own and played the game while recording it off my Elgato, because I am so with the times. And did commentary with it back to back. But that commentary was so boring solo that I was like, I can't upload this either. So, you know, take three, third time's the charm, and see if we can't get this right.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to, I'm glad you mentioned that this is going to be like the 2.5 worst playthroughs if we take Phil's slow beefs and then yours. Because I am like minus 5 people.
Oh, damn.
Like minus half a person, I mean. I don't really add anything to this playthrough. I take away from it. So there you go.
No, I would say you elevate this because you actually know what the hell's going on. I'm just like, oh, okay, yeah, I like that.
Well, I guess we'll start off with what happened. So it looked like you picked Brawler, like just being a Brawler in general.
Yes, I'm sorry, I don't know the combos between the two. So yes, I took the red magic, the one that's more focused on attacking.
And yeah, then it's sprawling.
I think it's called the Cleric, that's the medium armor start.
Yep.
So yes. And I found that preferable. I kind of played this before we did the LP, where I just dinked around with some of the settings.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't see a need for the healer magic.
Yeah, Solace is nice, but it's not too, like, it's not too necessary, really. Overall, I think that the Brawling Magic might actually be the most useful, but I personally find Deception to be the most fun, so...
And that's the one that's all about being sneaky and going into stealth and the like.
Yeah. Oh no.
Oh, connection error to the room. Yay, this LP's off to a good start!
These cutscenes are a bit weird because the enemies that appear in both of these I don't think appear really in the game. Like, this guy looks kind of like one of the later bosses.
I was going to say, we've never encountered this guy in any of the playthroughs we watched or the things we've recorded so far.
Yeah, it's weird because normally, you know, something that appears in like a cinematic cutscene like this, you would just sort of downscale the graphics on it, then use it in a regular game.
Mm-hmm.
I don't quite know why they didn't. Maybe it's because this... doesn't actually... I'm still not quite sure how this relates to, like, Harkin, because that one, that guy there, I'm pretty sure, is actually not Harkin, because of the title card that's about to come up.
See, how I always envisioned it was that was just leading up to the fight to Antanas. Oh,
here you go.
Oh, but it says a different time or different war, yeah.
So maybe that was like, maybe that happened with the War of the Judges, like way back when.
I wonder. Or is that maybe like after the events of the game happen, and like maybe that's a return to form? Like, oh, the cycle's just going to keep going.
Could be, depending on what. Actually, with one of the endings, yeah, it definitely could be.
Hmm.
Anyway, so plot of the game for people who don't know, the game kind of leaves you a bit. Open as far as the plot goes. All you really know is...
it starts you in media res.
Yeah, definitely. The main gist of it is that there's demons invading from somewhere, they worship a fallen god, and you're looking for a man named Antanas who's supposedly the leader of all humanity. Not supposedly, they outright say he is.
Now, is he... is he like the president of the world, or is he just like the last leader of the, like, you know, because of the Rogar invading, is he like the last head honcho?
He's like the president of the world. The judges put him in power after they left.
Gotcha.
Oh no, there's a couple of them. I do like this tutorial.
The tutorial is nice, I will admit. Normally they would just have some kind of like voiceover talking to you the whole time.
Yeah, or they do the Dark Souls thing where there's prompts on the floor, and the, but you know, you, it's up to you to follow them. I like it where it's like, oh, we'll give you, like, we'll tell you what to do here, and, you know, like, pause time and tell you what to do so you can get it fully.
Mm-hmm. No, I'm gonna set the record straight for a moment and just say that I've never played Dark Souls, so this is my only experience with it.
Oh, you never played Monster Hunter either?
Okay, so I played Monster Hunter for the PSP, like, way back when.
Okay.
I couldn't even tell you the name of the game. I just know that there's Monster Hunter, and there's a cat called Treshy who is a treasure hunter.
Mm-hmm.
And you could burn food. That's all I remember about it.
Gotcha. Well, they all have the same kind of fighting system. I mean, there's differences between the three a little, but for the most part, they all feel the same. Like, as far as your character controls.
It's locked. You're still losing blood, Kazlo.
So an interesting thing with this is that our main character here, Harkin,
I didn't let you
always starts as, like, kind of an asshole, but you can change how the other characters react to him, depending on the options you pick.
You're no use to me if you bleed to death. I will try to spare you the inconvenience of my death.
Everybody in this world is snarky. I love it.
Yeah.
We're looking for. How will we find him? He's the leader of all humanity.
Yep. Yeah, I guess I'll just fill you in on what I already said.
We'll find him.
So far, I've seen only corpses. No survivors.
The Rogar have clearly breached the walls of the monastery. Antanas would have given his life to protect his people. If he is alive, then some of them might have survived too.
There must be some way to open this door.
A switchback. Or a key.
Can we just get on with it, Kazlo, please?
Yeah. My favorite, honestly, is, like, dialogue, honestly, is when you find the key and you talk back to Kazlo, like, and you come meet Kazlo again.
There are too many of them. It is sickening to see them move.
Like, I almost forgot for a second, this isn't, like, a live play. I was gonna ask if you're gonna go get the, Oh, wait, no, you can't yet. That's right.
The hero shard?
Yeah.
Yes, that will come up later. I'm almost positive I go back and get it.
Yeah, because you need a key after the first boss. I do like how these, how all these tooltips here are fairly non-intrusive, like, fairly non-intrusive anyway.
Yeah. Like, it could have been irritating as hell, just pause time right there and slap that in front of you, but instead it's like, maybe you've played this game already. So here, it's off to the side, it's not going to interrupt you or anything.
Yeah, I'm also pretty sure the hammer you're given, if you two-hand it, can kill these guys with one charged-up heavy attack.
Probably. I think I was trying to show off, like, you know, okay, here's one-handed, here's what it's like with a block, here's two-handed, this is the difference.
Mm-hmm.
To put this in perspective again, I think I recorded these back in June, and it is now September 1st.
Yeah, it's been a while.
Yeah.
Took me a while to get through all the Celebi stuff.
Well, I can't blame you for that.
Yeah, especially when I lost one of the projects and had to redo it.
Alright, Mega, I got bad news for you. Video 4 is just gone. We're not doing it.
Huh.
How the mighty have fallen. 1, 2, 3, 5.
Yes. Sorry, guys, just can't do it. Gotta do laundry. Okay, good. I was wondering if you're gonna get the potion in there or not.
I'm a little confused by the placement of this bottle, because it's like the only thing hidden behind a breakable object.
Like,
you got the fake walls, which I can see, but I don't remember anything else in the game where it's like, hey, break down this, because there's this hidden area there. You got the barrels in the catacombs, and then that's about it.
Yeah, I think you might be right there.
It just... It feels very odd. It's like Chekhov's gun, except they never use the gun.
I can't really think of anything else that, I can't think of one that comes back into play if it does.
Hey, look, I pulled off a successful backstab.
Yay. And it is changing. I think if you do that, you probably won't get the tip for the backstab skull. Later.
The bones are moving.
How will I know how to backstab? No!
It does not feel like poison in my veins.
The tip for the backstab is done the exact same way as the, like, combat tips.
We have seen the others what happens next. I suffer those first. Then follows sanity. Brother William, Brother Peter and I won't let the disease take us. We will
We do find out what's the cause of this disease later, correct?
Yes.
Okay. I got an idea, but I'm not going to say it until we get to that point.
Sure.
Which I think will be until we start recording part 4, because part 3 had that come up and I didn't make the connection until now.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, I was just showing off what happens when enemies hit you.
That's what happened there.
Yep, so that's what happens when you take damage, guys. Your life bar goes down.
Mm-hmm. I know that the game has locational damage for the enemies. I'm a little curious if it has locational damage for you.
Dear Father, the fire's
on the
horizon.
I mean, I know that if you wear a shield on your back, it'll block enemy attacks.
That's true.
Be careful.
So I'm actually curious if you're not wearing the mask, if you'll actually take more damage or not.
Always seek refuge here in the monastery.
Like from that whatever bite attack? Happens,
you mean on top of having the reduced armor from not wearing it?
Please.
Yeah.
Be safe.
Okay. Hmm.
That might be something interesting. Because, I mean, I know that the studio is big on locational damage, and it's, after all, one of the big things for their next game, The Surge.
I'm looking forward to that. I'm a little surprised.
Yeah. I really like what they're doing with the combat system, how it's no longer doing heavy attacks and light attacks, now it's horizontal attacks and vertical attacks with the different buttons.
That is very neat. They kind of got it with this game, where they say, oh, heavy attacks attack from a different angle, but this one their new game feels more focused.
Yeah, definitely. Like, if this game was them figuring out what they want to do, the next game, or The Surge anyway, from what I've seen of it, looks like we figured out what we want to do, and now we know exactly what we're doing. Oh, traded blows at the very end.
You know, it's like a Japanese anime. We punched each other in the jaw, and then he dropped.
Mm-hmm. On the plus side, Kazlo can always refill your potions. So at least there's
yeah,
that.
Yeah, about that, I don't think I play smart here.
Don't take advantage of that?
Yeah, act surprised that I was kind of stupid and went, oh, okay, I can just do this.
Hmm. Did he at least talk to Kazlo after getting the key? Yes.
I found a key.
Is there any
what
other
are you
option?
Waiting for? Open the door. I could use some help.
Yeah. Oh yeah, you found the empty bottle, didn't you? Useful. Yeah, that's right.
So I did find the empty bottle.
So at least you did get a potion back, at least.
That is true. It's unfortunate that I didn't drink my potion to get full health, and then he refills all the potions, but, you know, hey.
Yeah. Gathering up your courage.
Well, it's a big door. I gotta build up my strength.
Now let's see if you get the boss's secret weapon. Where'd Kazlo go?
And there goes Sir not appearing in this game.
Hmm.
I get that the screenshot was very shaky cam, like a second of him bouncing off the ground through the door. But, like, how do you not put two and two together?
Yeah.
That guy goes out the door, my guy gets slammed into the wall. Was that, like, the same camera angle? I don't know.
You're in opposite directions of the boss, too. Oh. That's such an asshole move.
Even knowing that it was coming, I still got hit. I love this game.
Mm-hmm. On the plus side, at least his shield doesn't do any damage to you.
This is very true. Alright, so...
Oh. Yeah,
there we go. Already busted. First attack he did to me. So here I was, showing off the boss's abilities. I mean, I'm pretty sure we covered all of this in Phil and Slowbeast videos. But he's got a shield slam, a rush, and then he's got an ability right now where it leaves him open, and that's where you get your damage in.
Yeah.
And well, this game's teaching you right now about just, you gotta be patient, you're not gonna be able to kill the boss in 2 seconds, just take some damage in, walk out, stay alive.
Yeah, you can really chunk this boss's health with two hand heavy attacks, wow. Like, 2 hits almost took him down an entire quarter.
I really do like the cleric armor set that you start off with, where it's just like the best of both worlds. You get a decent two-hander, you get enough armor to protect yourself if you screw up your rolls, and you get the light rolls with it.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, I can do all of this with the shield on my back, too. I really like that.
Mm-hmm. It's just unfortunate that the shield doesn't only blocks like 90% of the damage.
Yeah.
But then again, if you read the description, it says that it's meant more for like ornate purposes than actual
defense.
Yeah,
it's like it's more ornamental than supportive.
That's another thing I really like, is I like how the descriptions actually tell you stuff about the items.
Yeah, so it's not just like, well, why does this shield only do 90?
Mm-hmm. And one of the descriptions I really like is for the hammer, actually.
Which hammer?
The hammer that you're using. It says that using a big weapon doesn't actually help you cast a bigger spell, but it just gives you the courage to do it anyway. That's basically the gist of it. This guy also has an ability that I don't think we've seen yet, which is a sword slash. He only does it after he breaks off some armor with the 2 notches. He'll huddle behind his shield and then charge at you and slash twice.
Oh.
Anyway, and then this final ability. I'm really surprised that anybody was caught by that final ability, honestly.
I'm guessing they're just expecting that it was only going to last, like, maybe a twirl, and they weren't expecting a full hurricane right now.
Even so. Man, I'd be so embarrassed if my kid did that.
Like, why is that embarrassing? I don't get it.
I really don't either.
Like, it's a sword dancer move, right? If he was holding a staff, would that be better for him?
I don't know. It's a shame he barely got hit by that boss. If it wasn't for that opening, you would have gotten the secret weapon.
It's why after I recorded this, I went back and did a warrior run and just kept at it, and I finally did it.
Mm-hmm. For anybody watching, if you want to play this game, I'd highly recommend getting that secret weapon, because the flame blast across the floor is so useful. It deals a lot more damage than the gauntlet, it has better range from what I remember, and like the gauntlet, it also bypasses defenses because it goes under the shields.
One of those lords Kaslo keeps talking about.
To put it in context here for people, this isn't my first time fighting the boss, so, you know, obviously I did better than Phil or Slow Beef, but even then, it's not that difficult of a boss.
Mm-hmm. I guess I should explain this just for somebody who hasn't watched the other two playthroughs for some reason. Each boss can drop a secret weapon, or like an upgraded weapon, I mean. You always get their boss's weapon after you beat them, and if you fulfill secret conditions during the fight, you'll get the upgraded version of it that retains some of the boss's abilities.
So, for... how do I word this? For some of the later bosses, there are scrolls that kind of give you an idea of what you gotta do to get the secret weapon.
Yeah.
But
or there's hints
guy,
before the boss fight.
Right. For this guy, there's nothing. So, like, what, is it just they expected you to get this weapon on, like, New Game or New Game Plus?
I don't know. It's just a very simple condition, anyway. It's just don't take any damage during the fight.
That's
so,
true.
Maybe, the, I don't know, maybe they just maybe it's just one of those things that's supposed to be obvious. That's what I'm guessing, anyway.
Hey, what we should do is take my one spell point, or my one experience in spell point, and give it to Slow Beef.
You should put all the, like, you should put almost all your experience in spell points and then stop right before you level it up.
Or just do a spell point run and not a tribute run.
Mm-hmm. All now,
right,
I know you
me,
like to raise endurance just a little bit so that you can wear
yes.
slightly heavier armor.
Yes, I do.
Yeah.
Come on, pass me. What are you doing?
Debating whether or not you should torture me with raising endurance or not.
I know, I'll do a luck run.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I'm doing... I think I said that I was going to build endurance to 10, and then I'll start throwing it into other stuff.
Mm-hmm. Alrighty. Did you bank the rest of the experience, or did you keep it on you?
I have 294 experience on me for some reason. I don't know why.
Hmm.
Because if I dropped a ghost so I could have life back when I died? I don't know.
Maybe you're planning on taking on the spider area, and you wanted a ghost just in case?
Maybe.
But that wouldn't really... Well, maybe you weren't thinking about it at the time. But whenever you enter a new area, you get 25 experience, so that you can always drop a ghost if you die there.
That is very true. Yep, that's a pretty crystal, Mega. Let's move on.
Maybe you're reading the spell tip. Now, do you go to the door to get the dialogue about Caslow?
I hope to God I did. Please, let me have some faith in myself, yes.
Alrighty.
Caslow. Caslow. Damn it.
I wonder where he went off to.
Alright, well, time to try the tutorial area again.
Yeah. Now let's see if you got that, if you get the backstab tutorial.
Let's see if I can get a backstab again. I'll be kind of shocked.
Oh, you do get a backstab tutorial.
I only did it to the one guy, so maybe that's why.
Yeah, because I never actually got it. Why did Slowbeef skip this tutorial?
Was there even an option to skip it? I'll be honest, I didn't really look.
It said push circle if you don't need directions.
Because he's played Dark Souls. Come on, you know how to riposte and backstab like that.
But what's funny is he screws up the backstab after skipping it. Nice.
Soon after banishing the god, the three men that were known as the Judges parted ways forever. Apart from their common goal, they were very different.
Oh, I see you role playing as a thief.
Three statues. Well, you know, if they're gonna leave this stuff around, I don't see their name on it.
And the so for anybody wondering, that's the armor set for the class that Mega did not pick.
But it is retained.
And at the very bottom of this, I believe he's going to get the armor class for the rogue, which is another class he didn't pick.
I really do like, too, that they don't lock you out of that. So it's like, yeah, you took cleric and you ain't feeling it. Here, try a rogue armor instead.
Yeah. And that audio log you picked up gave you tips about this thing called the Shard of the Heroes. And from what I remember, that ends up getting used later.
Yes, it does.
I believe it was in Video 3 that you ended up using that.
Oh, no, I'm being a coward. Oh, okay, I'm going for the shard first.
Yeah, I might as well get that.
Alright, backtracking.
At least you don't have to backtrack very far. Now, something kind of cool that I learned recently is that you can cancel out of Harkin's roll animation by kicking after you land. So you don't even actually need to wear heavy armor, you just have to kick after you land.
Oh, wow. I mean, when I do kicks, I only get... I get kicks when I don't want to kick, and then when I do want to kick, I don't. So that's it's nice to know, but it will never help me out.
Well, if you're not wearing a shield, you can also kick by just pushing L2.
Ah. I could hit L2 right now while two-handing it, and it would kick.
Yeah, so right after you land on your feet after the jump, you kick, and then you don't roll forward at all.
Excellent. Pretty object. Come on, take it.
I think you were just explaining what the Shard of the Heroes does. If I had to guess, anyway.
Why didn't I take the Shard of Heroes, start walking to the next area, and then to kill time, explain what the Shard does?
I don't know.
Because I'm an idiot, that's why.
Who knows, maybe you... No.
No, challenge room, that's right.
Oh, okay, good.
There is a reason for going back.
Yeah. I was hoping that it wasn't just to build your experience multiplier again.
4 hours later.
Yeah, and you didn't die on the first boss, and none of the enemies respawned. This is actually the first time I think I've seen somebody run through this area without the enemies respawning.
Well, unfortunately, we'll get the enemies back as I come out.
Yeah, that's true.
What a challenge!
Faithful disciple. Awesome piece.
I kind of like how the trinkets also don't really explain what they do. For some of them, you gotta take a guess. Obviously, this one says spellcrafters wore it to regenerate their powers, but later ones are like, oh, this one increased their luck in battle, that also made them more wary of dangers. You have to kind of go, what does that mean?
Mm-hmm. Something kind of neat, if you look at the Bulwark shield, or at least something kind of funny anyway, is it mentions how it's a standard shield for Rogar infantry, but very rarely does anybody use it. Because, aside from being really bulky, it also smells really bad. Something I can't really fault this game for, like, just because of the company that made it not being, you know, English, is how there's a few spelling mistakes when it first came out.
Like, so what, like that tooltip had a mistake or something?
Well, not that one, but just other ones where it says things like, be careful of drinking a potion in battle. If you get hit, you will loose the potion.
Well, it slides out of your hands. You go, oh shit, Butterfingers.
Mm-hmm.
In the early game, I really hate fighting these guys in close spaces.
That's not too bad, I thought.
It's kind of my anathema.
Mm. I mean, I get it because they do have the wide sweeping attacks, but as long as they only do the overheads, I think that they're not so bad.
It's very true. Alright, something you shouldn't do, guys, is just attack when you have no stam. You should try and let that build up so you can do a heavy attack to break their defense and then counter up with some light attacks.
Yeah, another reason too is if you attack when you have no stamina, you do half the damage you normally do.
God, I wish I had the gauntlet right now.
Shh. Well, you're gonna get it fairly. Uh-oh. Oh.
Right. Coward's way out.
Good thing you did. That hit would have killed you if you didn't.
I should have walked back over his corpse again just to hear him grunt.
Why is there no crouch button in this game? At least you can build up that combat multiplier a little bit.
Yeah, guess who forgot about that there was enemies respawn?
Hmm. Oh well. These guys are easy anyway. So let's see. Did you take on the spiders in this save file?
I don't think I did. I think I said, oh, okay, so when I play again with Lich, we'll go back to the spider area and see what it's like. And I don't think we ever did. Which
no,
is
we,
okay.
We did. We got the items there. And
are you thinking the first playthrough, or
in the playthrough that we continue?
Okay. We gotta go back anyways for a quest later.
Yeah, it'll be much later. There's an endgame item that you can only get at the very end there.
Mm. I remember Monk asking about his brother before we quit.
Oh, his brother's at the bottom of a different tower. He's in a room full of beer barrels.
Ah. While we were talking, I just broke the atheist run. I'm sorry.
Hmm. Oh, well. So, this is a damaged wall, really. You can destroy it if you want by raising your shield and sprinting at it.
And I think I was explaining that, but of course, because actions speak louder than words, I wanted to talk.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Yeah, you can use the monk staff right now. It's pretty nice.
Monk staff is so broken early game. I love it.
Yeah, it is. It gets outpaced pretty quickly by later weapons.
You know, I picked up the Bulwark Shield. I never even inspected it.
Ah, well. I don't think it would be very good for you.
We can't stand against such forces much longer. We must find a place to hide. A place with walls and soldiers. Mighty Antanas, we will be on our way.
Please, so let's see. What item do you use against the commander? Refugees. I'm going to guess that you don't go down to the catacombs to get heirloom.
I do not go to the catacombs. I said, let's just go the way an average Joe player would go. And, so, yeah, I don't know what weapon I can't remember.
I'm gonna guess you still give Yekka her dagger.
Oh, yeah. I'm a nice guy.
Mm.
Plus, Yekka deserves it. She's awesome.
Yeah. Yep, there's the rogue armor.
Alright, bye, spiders.
Yeah, I'll come back for you later.
I have arachnophobia, so, you know, it's alright.
Well, I remember in the lesser video quality playthrough, you tried taking them on, and then gave up after you died for quite a while.
Well, yeah, they crushed my ass, because I was still not respecting them.
They're pretty tough. It's hard to deal with them at first because you don't really know them. It's they're one of the enemies where you just have to get to the side or to the back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's funny seeing Phil and Slowbeef die to him, but there is a reason why they died to them. I'm not going to fault him on that.
Yeah. Oh man, Liku already has 5 potions.
So rare.
Something that's really nice, too, is being able to save without losing your experience multiplier.
Yes, and I think I just did a regular save because I forgot that leaving an area and entering a new one automatically saves you there.
Yeah.
So I was thinking I had to start all the way back by the first warden.
Yeah. But one thing I really like, too, is how people complain that the combat in this game is so slow, right? And they never use agility weapons.
Yeah, right?
Like, look at how slow this monk staff is.
Or, yeah, a fast, agile staff.
And then, of course, when you get Kmar, there's not really any reason to keep using this staff.
Is that what I use this? Because I'm trying to do the same kind of build we were doing on the lesser quality, so I think that might be the weapon I use.
Could be. Oh wow, you got the Marauder Great Axe pretty early.
Yeah. Don't think I used it though because it requires too much strength.
Yeah, and besides you prefer the faster weapons.
It's true.
Yeah, I prefer the slower, heavier weapons.
Boy, they're just introducing new enemies to... Oh no, that's the only new enemy. I'm an idiot.
Hmm. And new enemies will be coming up. You'll be meeting with the baby spiders.
Now, do I... Yes. Alright, awesome. Yay, Bride.
I'm very glad you remember this other staircase. Otherwise, you'd have to run down below every single time.
There isn't really a reason to come back this far, though, once you get past it, right?
Yeah, maybe you want to go back to that spider area.
Oh. Yeah, I guess that's true.
And you could also die, so...
That's also true. Yeah, and those won't reset when you die, so...
I'm guessing you save the monk?
No, you know what? I didn't really feel like I had a choice here.
You. Yeah, the game doesn't give you an option. Me.
Please. You're gonna see it's actually grayed out. I try hitting down and it won't let me.
Burns like Adir himself touched it. Something we talked over is for some reason Slowby thought that this monk poisoned his own hand. Too late.
Wait, what?
Yeah. There's only one way to stop the venom. We were too busy laughing, but Slowby was going, I think I gave away a bottle to that idiot monk who poisoned his own hand. You're a madman. You'll see the judges soon then.
I can't. I won't. It's in your hands. I'll do it. I won't do it. I won't do it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think I was making snide comments here.
Right. No choice at all. Be it.
So what have you ever done I won't do it?
Yeah. If you, it takes them a while to die, but if you just wander around for a while, you'll eventually find them just slumped over dead. You're not
one of the monastics. Did he drop any items? Markings.
Not from I remember. But you're allowed to keep, you still keep the axe from what I remember. Please, put the
axe down now. I'll always remember you, monk. Ooh, better weapon.
Well, to be fair, he did give it to you. I think it's one of those Deadpool things where it's like, I am keeping the axe. I mean, you did give it to me after all. And yes, I see the irony of the situation. You must have supplies. I feel really bad for anybody who lets this monk die. Because if you help him out for a while, yeah, he can upgrade your potions for you. I won't make it
there in this condition. So they heal more?
Yeah.
Nice. Alright, Mega, come on, we get it. There's no choice. Just take the potion.
You don't want asshole points, so pick the top option.
And they automatically switch me to one-handing this. I'm sure that's not going to bite me in the ass.
You didn't realize?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I didn't realize.
Huh.
Act surprised that I'm not the most observant person in the world.
At least it doubles the range of the weapon.
That is true. take bets on when I start to figure out that it's one-handed and not two.
When somebody shoots you in the back and your shield doesn't block it? Okay, good.
Oh, there we go. Yay, brain. Am I gonna backstab again? Oh, no. See, I always kick when I just... I wanted to backstab him. I hit the light attack button. Nothing.
Well, you kick by pushing forward at the at the exact same time that you hit R1.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if you're holding forward and you push R1, it'll work. And if you're not holding forward and push R1, it'll work. But if you let go of forward and then push forward again while pushing R1, you'll kick.
Gotcha. That must have been what I did.
So you're, like, doing the very specific thing that'll make you kick instead of backstabbing.
I backstab when I want to kick, and I kick when I want to backstab. What's going on?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel really bad for the Marauders, honestly, as far as that backstab animation goes. Because they're at just the right height, that instead of going into their stomach, it goes right into their crotch.
They have a trademark in Dick Lightning.
Well, this guy didn't even hear you.
I must have caught him when he's, like, scratching his chest or something, so he just thought that was what was happening.
Huh. Alright.
Oh, heavy armor that I can't wear because it's too heavy.
Yeah.
They don't growl at me.
It's also an awesome armor set. Oh.
I will say the lead up to the next boss kind of takes a while. Like, at this point, I kind of get the enemies and the mechanics.
Well, if you jog for it, it's like 20 seconds.
That's true.
Oh, you're not getting the gauntlet. Yet, anyway.
Not yet. There's guys down here that get my combat multiplier up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that monk staff is too good.
Ninth night on watch. How could the Rukar get inside the sacred walls of Keystone? They appeared out of nowhere. The graveyard is swarming with them. I need to alert.
That's like a Phil excuse. Whoa, that Rogar came out of nowhere.
That would never happen in an offline match.
Yeah. I want them to input, like, Phil sayings in, like, one of the Dot Hack games or something. Online combo!
Oh, now I decide to check my inventory? I guess it's better than checking my inventory every friggin' time I get an item, but...
I don't get why you're looking at persistence, because you looked at that after the first boss fight.
Yeah. Good job, past me. You're an excellent Let's Player.
Ah, well.
This will be riveting!
And you can't open that door yet, because the switch is on the other side.
That's right. Am I just trying to trip the flag? No, okay. I guess I just want this archer.
Stalking your prey.
Is there any explanation why this guy, even though he looks like the other guys, can see, and then the other guys can't?
Oh, the archers?
Yeah.
Well, he doesn't have growths all over his head. Those guys have growths over their eyes, and the archers don't. Those archers don't. The archers are actually Rogar, and the infested are actually not Rogar.
Oh. But they kind of look like the infested. With
yeah. Yeah, they got basically... They look like they have throat parasites. But... So yeah, they look similar to them, but they're not actually infested.
Gotcha. So I was wondering, like, how the hell does that work in that infested hierarchy? Like, oh, you can see here I have this crossbow.
Yeah. Now, the infested are humans that are turned into that, whereas the archers are always Rogar.
Gotcha. Oh, I never really noticed the tongue just, like, out there. I always thought it was just, like, a gaping maw.
Nah, it's carved in the shape of a dragon's head.
That was a scary tooltip, by the way.
I don't blame you for jumping backwards.
Well, you know, I just got this weird item. It's like, what the hell's going on?
Mm-hmm. Now, I really hate the shotgun setting before you put runes in it.
Yeah, default shotgun kind of sucks.
Yeah, explosive is not too great either. The only real problem with explosive might be better for that archer up there. But the only real good thing about explosive is getting behind shields and doing more damage than the projectile. But it just takes too long to explode.
Also, the windup's kind of irritating, where you can't let it go early until Harkin pulls it all the way back behind him and then slings it.
Yeah. I mean, there's also a charge up for it, but yeah. Did the gauntlet just make you too heavy to use with the shield?
It's either that, or I was like, all right, I don't like using the shield, so let me just go ahead and equip armor items.
Yeah, it looked like you were trying to mix and match your gear now to get the best set.
Right.
Without going in the yellow. On the plus side, at least all the armors still look really cool.
I'm not digging that hood. It looks like they're trying to go for like some kind of necromancer thing, and then like, oh, just throw armor on it.
Eh. Well, to be fair, if you read the description, I'm pretty sure it says that's one of the more like ceremonial gear.
Oh.
As if one wasn't enough.
I'm kind of pissed off at this archer though. Like, he attacks you from way far.
Yeah, the archers have huge range on them. Like, there.
Good thing I drank a potion.
What I did in this the first time I got here was I just shot the archer twice. Because I'm like, I'm going to deal with the archer with the gun and then take on the rogue.
I think it's just because the rogue aggroed onto me too early that I couldn't just stand there and shoot him twice.
Yeah, well, you also rolled backwards to deal with the rogue, too. And the rogues are not too aggressive, like the vanguards, I mean. But, so that's why I was doing that.
My research is over. I dare to claim that this gauntlet does only one thing, but it does it rather well. It eats hatred like a hungry lion and spits it out like a dragon spits fire. Its bearer can wield it like a horrible weapon, but his soul must not be pure. A shattered soul will make the most out of this device.
So if I played Harkin good, like at the end of the game, he did like all the good choices, would that make it so he couldn't use the gauntlet anymore?
I don't think so, because, I mentioned like a shattered soul in general. Where is it? And like your soul must not be pure. It's not like he'll become a pure soul just by doing a few good acts.
This doesn't concern you.
It's the best character in the game.
Whatever you want, you won't get an answer from a dead man.
Seems it's your lucky day, altar boy.
I believe this character is one of the monks that gives you a quest later, if you let him live here.
Oh, wow.
What was that about?
They're liars, and worse besides. Not only did they steal my family valuables, but they've hidden the pathway.
Some people tell her to drop him, and I honestly don't know what happens if you do, because you actually can run down to the place he drops later on. I'm not sure if he drops an item or not. Hold
power. So you can find his shattered body down there?
Pretty much.
Gross.
Why are you so sure it's still here?
It's in the Book of Lineage, and the book does not lie.
You sure those friars stole from you? I've always taken them for bookworms, not lifters.
Don't be a fool. The men in here are just as twisted.
I'm not too sure why. Well, actually, no, never mind, I do. I was about to say, I don't know why Yetka doesn't like Antanas. But on second thought, yeah, I can see why.
They bled the villagers dry over the years. They think people forget that the truth gets buried.
As far as I can tell, Yetka's actually one of the few people who worships Adir.
I know what they did.
Oh.
Yeah, I got that because they mentioned that the Rogar actually don't like. Oh yeah, don't say the third option, by the way.
No, come on, let's do it. Oh.
Don't want her pissed off at you.
No.
Anyway, so they mentioned that the Rogar don't actually mind or pay any attention really to the people who worship Adir, and they can actually talk and have conversations with them. And when Yetka goes into the Rogar realm, she never actually kills any of the Rogar, and the Rogar ignore her, as far as, like, when she's going around places. And, at one point very late in the game, she actually does have a conversation with one.
Oh, wow.
Faith or endurance?
I'm probably just doing endurance 10 and then 1 into faith, and then from there on out, it's going to be a faith run.
Yeah, if you ever need any more, like, weight things... Oh yeah, I remember you do that. I was gonna say, if you need any more, like, carry-on weight, you can always just put luck runes into equipment.
That's very true. We'll get those when we go to the Rogar homeworld.
Mm-hmm.
No. Okay.
I want to say that I really like the rune system.
Yep, it's the best armor there.
You could equip warrior, but it wouldn't really get you much, and it's a lot heavier.
Yep, look at all the items I got, viewers.
Just gonna quickly brag about that.
Yeah, I found all the items already, what about it?
Okay, now do you manage to kill the spider that's under this tower?
Well, I know I get Yetka's dagger, so yes, I eventually kill the spider. I don't remember if I get it on the first attempt.
Well, you don't have to kill the spiders to get her dagger, because you can just drop off. You can drop off that cliff there.
I think too linearly is the problem. And his shield being no less than a weaponry masterpiece. That's most peculiar, as I would never have suspected. Oh, it's gotta be one-handed for the range, buddy. No wonder he had the most
dedicated followers. And there's also an anvil in this room.
Yes, there is.
That'll come into play much later. A little past the third of the game.
I think because I have rage that I'm able to beat the spider.
Gotcha.
Because I just go heavy attack ham in.
I forget how good or bad Lethal Secret is. Normally there's a rogue in here, but you killed him outside.
Right.
I think there's an empty bottle in here too. Oh, no.
Well, we got, I think, the better-looking chest.
And you also got pain. I really like the description for pain.
And that is a face-scaling weapon, so that'll scale better for me than the staff I was wearing.
Yes. And then you got the cool robes.
Yeah!
So far, I think my favorite set in this is the Traitor Armor set.
And that is the one you get for smashing the statues in the Rogar world, right?
Yep. Oh, you didn't pull the lever to open up the door.
No. I didn't see a lever. What lever?
Oh, it was in that room.
There was a lever?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, how am I supposed to get to the commander, then?
Oh, no. You're locked out.
Alright.
Better sneak around the spider.
Yeah, I'm doing some Metal Gear Solid 5 shit here. Man, this is just like what I did to kill Skullface.
Sure is nice you don't have to worry about stamina burning when that's up.
It's very true. That being said, I can't believe how little damage I'm dealing to this guy. Holy shit.
You have to hit him in the abdomen to do the good damage to him.
Yeah.
Because the spider's one of the enemies with locational damage. The best time to hit him is actually right then, when they're about to spit out an egg. Because their abdomen's nice and exposed.
Alright, take bets, how many times?
Uh-oh. only use one potion, you still got a lot to go. The only thing you gotta worry about is the little spiders, just in case they poison you.
Right. Like, now.
And yeah, like now. And his there eggs poison you when they explode.
Alright, two potions.
Oh, almost up the abdomen.
God, I hate the spiders so much!
Oh no! Like I said, you gotta get to the side or behind them.
Yep.
They're manageable then, but otherwise, if you're at the front, they could just, well, like, bum rush
combo
you. Like
you.
Yeah.
I was locked out.
And that's actually the first death of the playthrough.
Hooray.
Nice.
Regrets. I've had a few.
Well, at least you're doing it your way.
The biggest question is whether it's the right or wrong way.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there we go. Yep. I kind of feel bad. We talk so much about the mechanics in the Slow Beef and DSP videos where it's like, I don't want to bring them up again because they'll be like the third time somebody's heard about it.
Yeah, it's, I'm like having trouble thinking of like which mechanics I did or didn't mention. I guess I could go into the anvils. They're important because later in the game, you're going to meet this guy who can put runes into your armor and stuff. And once you give him this teleportation crystal, he'll be able to appear anywhere there's an... or he'll be able to take you away to his realm anywhere there's an anvil.
So that way you don't have to keep running to the Rogar world to communicate with him.
Yep, exactly.
Alright.
He's a pretty nice character. He's another one of the characters that's kind of a sarcastic dickhead. Oh, the spider's down again. Huh. I'm not too sure of the... Oh, nice.
Yeah, it only did 81 damage. And now I'm locked out of healing or total stam.
Yeah, well, oh, I did get you.
Yeah, good job. Good job past me. You're amazing at this game.
I was going to say, at least you stopped them from making an egg. Ram might actually be pretty good for, or the gun too, would be pretty good at stopping the eggs from poisoning you.
At least I picked up my souls. Oh, wait.
No. You can get it third time's the charm.
Yeah, let's hope. Maybe this will be the remaining, like, 30 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
That'll be fun.
No, lock on.
Oh, I'm locked on, just the wrong enemy.
Mm-hmm. Something I was actually really surprised at with the Slow Beef's gameplay was how the archers can actually hit the infested.
Did that occur?
Yeah, it happens in video one. Oh, he I runs past one of the infested. Oh, you missed an item. He runs past one of the infested, and the archer ends up accidentally shooting it, and I don't think it deals any damage to the infested, but it knocks the infested on the floor.
Oh, that's... Okay, now I know what you're referencing.
Oh, one of those moments.
Yeah.
I was running for a second. I'm like, did you unlock? I like those moments, especially when they happen during leaping attacks.
Is your PlayStation not able to handle this game? You turned the graphics up too high?
Yeah. Something else we talked over was Slow Beef at one point just laughing after that moment happened and going, maybe the game's just bugged.
Yeah. The obvious slowdown noise, those, like, the focus on the event. Yeah, that was just a bug. A glitch.
Clearly. So, it looked like you were trying to favorite one of your items?
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
I think I was.
Oh!
I hate this goddamn spider so much.
That was a quick clone death. It's a shame you're not even close to your ghost to get health back yet.
For some reason, my previous ghost, I was close enough two stories up to get it, but this time, nah.
I think maybe they just have, like, a much, like, I think their height is a lot better rather than their width.
Nah. Alright, it's time to play as, like, a cover-based shooter. Because he can't leap at me if I'm hidden behind. God, he kills my clones so fast.
Yeah. He kills you so fast, too.
Are the clones' health based on your faith or your vitality scaling?
As far as I'm aware, they're based on both faith and how many levels you put in the clone.
Oh, okay.
So, like, you're only level 1 right now, so the clone doesn't have very much health.
Yep, good job, Mega. If I recall correctly, this becomes a battle of attrition.
I think he has three little spiders out currently.
Yeah.
You should watch out for them, they can poison you too.
And big guy's just gonna ignore me? That helped, actually, thanks.
I think after he killed your clone, he didn't realize you were still here.
Well, that guy was really easy to kill for the third time, let me move on.
Maybe the spider's grinding your clone's experience.
Yeah, right.
It's like, oh, he's got a combat multiplier of, like, 1.6 now.
See, that's what I was doing with leaving the spider eggs up. I was just trying to get my combat multiplier back up.
Gotcha.
So, like, I'm losing 298 experience here. Let me just work my way back. What are you even aiming at, idiot?
You're locked onto the egg. That's going to
poison myself. Yay!
Oh, you killed it right after the little spider came out, so you didn't get poisoned. Alright, time to grab it when there's only 47% left.
Yeah, right. It's better than nothing.
Something with the game too. The spider keeps on almost leaving itself open for, like, an abdomen attack.
I love it. The AI is smarter than me.
At least you finally got him.
This is where I decide, fuck it, I don't care anymore, and I just went at him, even with no stam.
Yeah, it paid off, at least. And on the plus side, that spider doesn't respawn.
Hooray! It only took four potions.
At least the third time was the charm.
And then I'm gonna die to like a pit or some shit.
Or to this guy somehow. You're just gonna forget that he resurrects himself.
This is one of the stronger guys, right? So you could have like one-shot me there.
He's stronger, but he's not one of the super strong guys. He only has one arm. The super strong guys look like this, but they have two arms instead.
Gotcha. So I think I was just showing that this would be a shortcut to the catacombs if I helped out Yetka. And unfortunately it's locked off right now, so.
Yeah, we can unlock it later.
Yeah.
Oop.
Having trouble negotiating that bench there, Harkin? Alright.
Oh, I was wondering where you're going, but yeah, you're gonna drop down on the key.
Yes.
I think
I gotta get my potions back. I can't go on.
I think so far I'm the only person that I've seen who jumped up to the key. I would not recommend doing that.
You got some balls to jump for it.
Yeah, I wouldn't recommend doing that. It's a lot harder to do.
Just for context, I put on heavier armor, so when I dropped down, I didn't roll to my doom, nor would I roll if I did that.
Yeah. Because if your weight is in the yellow at the bottom there, then you don't roll after you do any sort of jumps or falls. It sure makes jumping across pits really easy, because you can keep on sprinting after you land then, and then you can just go from leap to leap.
Right.
Briefly turn into Mario. Now, is this guy going to shoot you in the face?
Probably.
Yep.
I thought I was walking slow enough, but I guess not.
Yeah.
Best time to use a leaping attack is when you have no stam.
It's very rare that I find that leaping attacks don't drain all your stamina.
Alright, so now that we got that key, we can progress here.
I'm very curious if you're going to get Quake before you meet the commander.
This is my sixth night on watch.
Because I can just imagine that Quake would just crash the commander. Like, just wreck him.
Maybe the Rogar have retreated.
I don't remember.
Villagers can return to their homes.
Because remember, Quake really crushed that later boss.
Yeah, that was ridiculous.
I was actually surprised at how powerful it is against him.
Is it just because it was a rank 3 Quake, or because I had too many points in Faith at that point?
Bit of both. The spell hit him multiple times as the hammer was coming down, because there's multiple parts on him that you can target.
Just get out of my face!
There's another way to cheese that fight, too, by the way, if you put fire in your gauntlet, because the gauntlet ignores the boss's armor, so it just takes health from him directly.
Oh, pretty sneaky, sis. Yeah, I can do its blind two-handed attack, too.
Now, you gotta watch out when you will go up to this next door, because sometimes one of the infested can hear you, and he'll be waiting at the door.
Like right now? Oh.
Yeah, if one of the infested, if you sprint at the door and one of the infested hears you, he'll immediately grab you when you open it and start eating your face.
Yep, Rogar didn't hear the ground pound. Nope, we're good.
I do find it really cool that it seems that a lot of the enemies have sort of like random behaviors.
Yeah, like Bob here is more lax than the other guys would be.
Yeah, but I mean, even as far as that goes, like, remember there's one Rogar Vanguard that if you just leave alone long enough, he starts dancing on the spot. And there are some enemies that I fought that when they get low on health, they sometimes run away. And we... Oh yeah, he's getting up. And in Slowbeef's gameplay, we saw it where if you equip some really big weapons sometimes, the archers will sometimes run away from you, even before you hit them. But it doesn't always happen like that, and I find that kind of cool.
Hopefully they carry that over to their next game.
I hope so, too.
Boy, items galore.
Well, you do have a pretty nice combat multiplier right now, right?
1.5-ish?
That's pretty decent. The maximum multiplier you can get right now is 2.
And there's a way to increase that?
Yeah, there's an item you can get later. Yekka's dagger. There's an item you can get later. It's a trinket that raises that to 2.5.
Oh, wow. I was going to say, what's the highest you got, but now I think I know.
Now, he didn't give you any experience, so he's going to get back up.
Which is why I think I'm...
Or I'm pretty sure he's... Right. Oh, I guess you just ignored him. Pretty sure he didn't give you any experience anyway. Oh well. His play dead tactic worked.
Alright, Mega, you've been in this room before. Okay.
Yeah. Where did the body go? He's not here anymore. Well, he must be still be dead.
I think I just have to clear out that area and then I can progress to the boss.
Let's see. I believe you get prejudice over here.
I thought you were born with that. Mm-hmm. Or maybe it's just if you live in the South.
It's something you get as you go along in life. Oh, you got the worst. Ooh! Okay.
Yeah, I
the
think
game
I'm
gave that to you.
Oh, yeah, no. But it didn't matter.
Okay, that's pretty great.
Smartest move is to jump over to a little area and fight two guys over there.
That was awesome. The game stopped you from falling down in a pit just to kill you on the other side. Are you going to use a Ghost Merge Shard?
Yeah, I was like, screw this.
That's fair enough, I think.
I'm not
that much experience
that
right
again.
Now. Oh, well, you're going to miss out on prejudice, but yeah, we can get that later.
You again? Maybe you want to help me out. You see, I'm
prejudice isn't really necessary, and for your build, I don't think it would really help you out a lot.
Simple, rusty. Seen it by any chance?
You mean this worthless dagger?
I love the option of, do I look like a man who cares? Her response to it's great. She just goes, you look like my mother's worst nightmare.
Since I've no need to look in the catacombs anymore, you can have this key.
I must go.
Suit yourself.
So in the Warrior playthrough, I went up to a point before all this. Where am I going?
I don't know. You got 800 experience, and I guess you're not going to bank it?
No. It's 800 experience. You got to hold on to that.
Gotcha.
This is the Prussian era. The banks are worthless. Mm-hmm. So in the Warrior playthrough, I played up to the point where I stopped with Thus, and I got Yetka's key to go through the catacombs to see if I could cheese doing the commander and the, what's his name? Worshipper?
Yeah.
And you can kill the champion, but then no guard comes out of the door. Where are you going, Mega? Yep, just wasting everyone's time. Maybe I'm going back to the spiders? Why would I do that? Regardless.
Now you got
so
the courage.
No guy comes out by the champion, so you have to go back, find Caslo, and he tells you, okay, so there's a guy in the court. Yeah, that's what I came back for.
Sweet.
There's a guy in the court, and there's a guy in the graveyard that we gotta kill. So you can't, like, secrets break at all.
Yeah, well, you can still get the items early and stuff.
No, I'm trying to get prejudice.
Oh, okay. I think to get prejudice, you have to beat Dark Souls before playing Lords of the Fallen. And you can sort of secret spike, by getting the items and stuff. Unlocking the shortcuts.
That's true.
Freeing one of those monks.
I was just thinking that they'd be like, oh, hey, you got here. Well, here, Antanas is going to give you shit, and oh, by the way, you got to do this still.
Yeah. To be fair, that the captain of the guard flat out says that he's not letting you in, and then Caslo later on is the one who convinces them to let you in, and he says that he's not letting you in until you deal with the other two lords.
Ah.
And then he also tells you to like stop it from making like stop their teleportation ability.
Yeah, just keep fighting this guy in the closed space like that. Smart.
Yeah. It really sucks when these guys use their flurry attacks in these kind of enclosed spaces.
Yeah.
Cuz that just chunks your health. Oh, kick him in the pit. Are you going to kick him? Oh.
It would be nice, but like I said, when I want to kick, I can't kick, and when I don't want to, I can.
Hmm. You're never going to get that achievement.
That's the only thing holding me back from a platinum trophy. Excuse me, sir, I need to... Okay.
Alright.
Alright. It's 100% run now.
Yeah, going to examine it.
Which, it's an agility, so surprise, surprise, I can't wield it yet.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, but what else can I do to waste more people's time? Go back to the spiders?
Let's see, you can double check to make sure you got the Shard of the Heroes.
Yeah. I could go through the catacombs part way and then go, screw it, I'll go the right way.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good. Commander boss fight here. Oh, you can open up that switch to open that door there. Like you can hit it.
Yeah. Okay, see ya.
Now, are you going to bank your experience?
That would probably be the smart thing to do.
Yeah. Banking it also resets the multiplier.
That's true.
Well, let's see. You still need to make one more spell before you can get Quake.
I think because I scroll down the Quake to see the faith requirement, I think I'm trying to do that.
I don't think you have enough faith either. I'm pretty sure you need 15.
Yeah, that would be a problem. Let's go grind!
Shh. You're only one away. Well, you do have an attribute point shard. So, you know, you could put two in there, then use the attribute point shard to get high enough.
I could. I'm not the biggest fan of doing that because I don't see the point in raising the thing higher than it needs to be. Like, if I just go ahead and get my experience, and then, like, towards the end game, I can be like, alright, throw all my other remaining attribute point shards I got.
Mm-hmm.
Watch out! There are some freaks on your side.
I like how there's a shockwave from the hammer, even if you don't hit them directly.
That's a big hammer.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, there's 24... or there's 20 minutes left, so...
Well, it can't all be the commander.
Let's hope. That was necessary.
Mm-hmm. I like how after a bit, Harkin kind of gets used to them appearing.
Yeah, he doesn't even comment on the worshipper, does he? He's just like, yeah, okay.
Yeah. You know, they don't even play a special cutscene for it. It's just, eh.
Here you go. Here's a boss. Whatever.
Mm-hmm. So let's see. Do you remember to use the gun on the worshipper? Or commander, I mean. Ooh. That's what we call a sucker stab.
Get in there. Get in there, kid. Come on. Oh. That's why I didn't.
Feeling out the worshipper, see what he's gonna do. Okay, come on. Oh.
Yeah.
Remember one of Phil's complaints to this guy?
Which was what? That he couldn't deal any damage to him?
No, he said that this fight would be better if you could break the shield. Take away all challenge.
So then, because this game plays by the same rules as you do, couldn't the enemies just break your stuff then?
Exactly.
Well, now you gotta spend souls on repairing your items. Well, that would be Dark Souls of it.
Yeah, pretty much. Speaking of other Dark Souls-like games, played the beta for Neo.
Oh, that did get recently re-released. How was that?
I thought it was fairly fun. Still has many serious issues. Both bosses in the beta are still terrible. Like, that's something so far, is that Neo has terrible bosses. Just absolutely awful.
Was it improved over the alpha, any?
I would say the gameplay was, yeah. They removed weapon degradation and equipment degradation.
I do like that.
Yeah, I mean, I'm kind of iffy on it, because in the alpha at least served a purpose. Because, you know, at least you... It served the purpose because you would keep on... Enemies dropped a ton of equipment.
Oh, okay. So it's not like Lords where once you get the item, that's it. You don't get a multiple of it.
Yeah, exactly. Now you're up against the Vanguard. Because something neat about this guy is that usually if you... Even if he shoots out the spark, and I think it's... They might have fixed it by now. But when he shoots out the spark, if you take him down a notch when the spark's out, it'll actually go to the wrong spot. Because, you know, it goes to summon the Marauder, but you hit him down the notch afterwards, so the Vanguard spawns instead.
Uh-huh.
So, I got mixed feelings about taking out equipment degradation like that.
As a guy who played World of Warcraft for a long time, I'm happy to see degradation go, because that was the worst shit about fighting. Alright, time to pay the repair bill.
Yeah.
Can you guys pull your head out of your ass? This isn't a hard fight. I'd like to save some bank. Thanks.
There's a degradation also in Neo happens fast enough that it actually is kind of a threat. It's not like in Dark Souls where you'll go 7 hours and then it'll be like, your weapon is about to break. And you'll be like, why is this even here?
I gotcha. So they had it, but it was completely worthless because it didn't occur enough.
Basically, yeah. There's no point to it. It would just serve as an annoyance where it happened in the middle of a boss fight after 7 hours, and then you'll be like, well, I guess I gotta switch to a different weapon and do a lot less damage now.
Does it occur on just being hit, just using the item?
Just dying? Using the item.
Oh, wow.
Like, every, like after 10 swings or so, the weapon will lose, like, maybe 1 point of durability. Out of, like, 500.
Prepare to die!
And then they did something really stupid in Dark Souls 2, where you didn't get any good replacements for the weapons that you got, but they also tied the equipment to your frame rate. So if it was running at 60 frames per second, your equipment would degrade twice as fast.
Oh, wow. Okay, that's...
Or even faster, because it registered it as just having more hits depending on how many frames you were hitting for. Man, magic sure does suck. Look how useless magic is.
Even if you just took prayer, that would change the game so much.
Yeah, prayer lets you do ridiculous things to this guy, like just chunk him. Anyway, so one of the reasons that the bosses in Neo suck, especially the new one that they introduced that kind of killed my interest for the rest of the game, is the boss's ability is that she can paralyze you, but at the same time, you also get stun-locked when you get hurt, when you're low on stamina. So that basically means that the boss's ability is to infinitely combo you until you die, and there's no way you can get out of the stun if she hits you.
So, and then basically you're too afraid to do any kind of move because if you lose too much stam, that's it.
Yeah. But she takes off a huge amount of stam, and if she hits you once, she can combo you until all your stam's gone. Oh, I see what you're trying to do. So if you use the Shard of the Heroes here during a boss fight... Yeah, you normally if you use it outside of a boss fight, it'll allow you to respect your character. And if you use it during a boss fight, the boss can run over to destroy the statue. Maybe the commander didn't do that because he was still so full on HP. Or so little on HP, I mean. Has so little left.
In this fight, for some reason, he never goes and attacks it. And it left me... Like, I'm pretty sure the rest of the video is me just trying to egg him into attacking the statue.
Hmm.
Where I'm like, alright, so maybe I have to wait until he summons the dude to trigger the flag or whatever, and it just never occurred.
Yeah. Luckily, though, there's another way of getting the weapon out. Because if you use it outside of a boss fight, it'll let you respect your character. If you use it in the fight, like, against a commander, it'll give you the boss's weapon. Or not the boss's weapon, judge's weapon.
I believe it still allows me to use it, because the commander never broke the statue.
Mm-hmm.
And then a boss fight later breaks it for us.
Yeah.
Yeah, so here it is. I'm just like, alright, you're gonna attack the statue anytime soon, buddy?
Maybe you also have to lead him over to it a bit more.
Yeah, you're gonna see me kite him over there.
Huh. I'm not too sure why I didn't go for it.
So if you guys ever plan on using the Shard of Heroes to unlock the class weapon early in the game...
Use it at the start of the fight.
Yeah.
Don't save it for the very end. It's basically how it goes. Because even that second boss fight later, you have to take off quite a bit of his HP before you broke it.
It's very true.
Maybe they only break it after losing a certain amount of HP after you put the shard in.
I'm thinking that it's triggered on whenever he summons guys. Like, after he comes out of the summon, then he goes, alright, now it's time to break it.
Ah, okay, gotcha.
So, because he was below the quarter notch, you said, alright, I can't break it anymore.
Gotcha. Come on, Commander.
Best place to try and avoid shockwaves is in these bushes. You can see him coming a mile away. It doesn't make it hard at all.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, see, I got him right in front of the statue. I'm like, okay, he's gotta attack it.
Oh, well.
No.
Yeah, that's something that's really annoying in Neo, is that in Neo they have a ton of trees, whose sole purpose, it seems, is just to block the camera. They've also got the same issue as Dark Souls, where the camera can get stuck inside your body.
So is Dark Souls now going to be the knockoff Dark Souls, and Neo's going to be Dark Souls?
Well, Dark Souls was always kind of the knockoff game because it's just combining a bunch of systems from other games. There we go.
There we go.
For the record, I do think that Neo plays a lot better than Dark Souls. And
it
Lords of the Fallen, for that matter.
It feels more fluid, or just... It
the controls feel a lot
more
tighter
rewarding.
And more responsive, for the most part. Except for that whole really annoying bit where you get stunned after you lose your stamina. That's still really annoying.
I get that it's different from all the other games, but I also feel like there's a reason why the other games don't have that mechanic.
Yeah, another thing too is that when you get hit in that game, you're kind of defenseless. Like, when you get hit in Lords of the Fallen, you can recover very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
When you get hit in Neo, there's a few times where it's just like, I get hit, and I'm like, there's nothing I could have done to get out of that combo.
Phil Simulator 2016.
Basically, because you just can't recover. Yeah, see, you got the Special Commander Shield.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, it's strength-based, so...
Yeah.
Probably never gonna see it.
I dink around with it for my Warrior playthrough, and I kind of liked it.
It's a fun little move.
I felt that it got outclassed pretty quickly, though.
Yeah, it's a... You don't really want to use it for, like, a ranged attack specifically. And there's how you can reset stuff. Anyway, you don't want to reset... you don't want to use it for, like, a ranged attack specifically. You want to use it as, like, a bonus to your defensive ability. Like, where you
gotcha.
Use the shield wall. Because somebody will be attacking you, you put down the shield wall so that their attack doesn't deal any damage to you, and then you blast them when they're reeling back from hitting your shield.
I gotcha. Then I was using that completely wrong. Hooray me.
Yeah, it helps out a lot during the champion fight when he's charging at you.
Oh, you can use the shield wall against that.
Yeah, because normally when he charges at you, and if he hits a wall, he actually won't get stunned. He'll just turn around and punch you in the face if you try attacking him. We're not making any experience?
I think I was calling the video here, but there's still... How much time to go? Oh, you know what was happening? All right, so I was recording this on my Elgato and using the default program that came with it. What the hell is it called? Game Capture HD.
Yeah.
And what was happening was the recording part. So on the main screen, it looked fine. But the part where it's showing me how much it was, where it was in the recording was staggered. So it would be like 5 minutes behind. And I was like, well, I'm ending the video. But if I hit end now. Does it turn off the recording? So, like, halfway through the commander fight, the video just ends?
Ah.
So, I was like, alright, then I guess I'll just wait until I get to a certain point in the video and then hit the button here. So, yeah, so the rest of the video is just me sitting at this screen.
Are we going to watch you open up, like, the PlayStation browser and see really shameful internet history?
Dark Side Phil love letters.
You're going to open up that like, slowy, jerking off video?
Alright, so that was Lords of the Fallen, everyone. That was video one. We'll return with video two with post-commentary like this one again. Video three will be some timey-wimey shit, in that we'll have it already had recorded. And I think that was after Slow Beast video four?
I believe so.
Yeah, and then after that one... We'll sometime in the future start playing this again, so then we'll jump back into the future again and be right here now.
Mm-hmm.
Or as Moffat just says, screw it and throw your hands up.
It shouldn't take too many more sessions, actually, to beat the game. You're proceeding
cool.
along through it at a fairly good clip.
That's good.
It all depends on how many side quests you want to do.
Let's do them all, why not?
Yeah, I'll do all the ones I can really think of.
Alright guys, we'll catch you later.